butternut squash casserole for Thanksgiving. And we're starting with a fresh squash. And to prepare your squash, you have to wash. I've already washed it. Now I'm gonna cut the ends off. A little bit pretty firm there. Make sure you've got a good sharp knife. And then after you cut the ends off, you want to split it. Split it right down the middle lengthwise. We've done that. Next thing we need to do is scoop out the seeds and the stringy looking flesh. We'll scoop those out. Use a spoon or whatever you want to use. Just have to get in there with your hands. So now I'm putting the second half, scooping it out. Now I think that's pretty good. So now I have a large, actually it's a large cake pan, or you can use a baking sheet. And I've sprayed it with cooking oil, cooking spray, pretty heavy. I'm gonna put it face down on there for, and I've got my oven preheated to 325. And as soon as that heats up, I'm gonna pop it in the oven for about an hour and go from there. Okay, we've got our butternut squash out of the oven and it's nice and soft. And I'm gonna start scooping that out. It's still kind of warm. We'll scoop that out into a mixing bowl. Okay, we've got our butternut squash scooped out. I'm gonna mash it up just a little bit with my potato masher, potato ricer. Easy. Now I've got a cup of packed brown sugar, about a third a cup of milk, a quarter cup of butter, thereabouts, two eggs that I've beaten. Half a teaspoon of salt. And then in this, I've got a half teaspoon of cinnamon, quarter teaspoon of allspice, and a quarter teaspoon of cloves. And then 1 teaspoon of vanilla. I'm gonna stir that up. Casserole dish that I oiled up with cooking spray. Pour that into that casserole. Set that aside. Now for the top quarter cup of packed brown sugar. Quarter cup of flour. And then I got about 3 tablespoons of cold butter. We're gonna cut that in with a pastry blender. You can also do this with your fingers or a food processor. So, got that pretty good. Now I've got about a quarter cup of, maybe half a cup of chopped pecans. Mix that in. And we're gonna sprinkle that on top. Guarantee my wife will be liking this because anything that's got pecans in it, she loves. So I guarantee it'll be a hit with her. Okay, now we'll
put that at 375 for about 20 minutes and check it, see if it's what it looks like. The top even looks done, brown. Crispy.
Okay, we've got it out of the oven. We ended up going about 30 minutes and it's nice and bubbly. And our butternut squash casserole for Thanksgiving. And you probably want to cook this a little bit before you're ready to serve it and let it set, because it's going to be just a little bit gelled, and after it cools it should thicken up. So there you have the butternut squash casserole for Thanksgiving. And please like, share, and subscribe, and ring that bell.